Hello and welcome to PDFSupply.com. Today we're going to be testing an IC693 CPU323. This is described as a 10-slot rack with embedded CPU, as you see in front of you. And it's being powered by an IC693 PWR330 power supply. I have the power supply powered up, as indicated by the power LED, and the CPU is okay according to the self-diagnostic, and that's what this LED means right here. So if you start this process, if you feel like you have a CPU 323 that may have a problem, the first thing that you do want to check, of course, when you power it up, is that you have an okay light. If you don't have an okay light, it's very likely that it's a troubled processor, there's something wrong with it, and you won't be able to follow this test. So our goal here is to get the processor into run mode on its own with no other modules and to keep it in run mode. And to do that, we're going to use Prophecy Machine Edition. So in Prophecy Machine Edition, what I've done is I've selected a new blank file, and under main rack, under CPU on the drop-down, if you double-click on CPU or right-click on CPU, you can replace the module, and I've replaced the default module with an IC693 CPU323 and a PWR330. So the same physical presentation I have in front of you is what I have in the Prophecy Machine Edition under my navigator bar. Okay, so the next thing I'm going to do is click the lightning bolt icon, which is on the top left corner, and that's the online offline button. Get connected to the processor. Okay, so once that's done, I'm going to click the green handprint icon, which is toggling it to online mode or program mode. All right, so now that that's done, I'm going to the top menu bar under target. Halfway down is online commands. When you click that, another window will open up and you want to select clear. So a clear memory will pop up and it's going to ask you what you want to clear. In this particular case, all we're doing is just a simple get the processor into run mode test. So the only things that we want to clear is controller fault table and I/O fault table. And select OK. Are you sure you want to continue with this? Yes. Don't select anything else that you may lose something that you have saved. Okay. So once that's done, we're going to go and click the download and start active target button, or F9, which is the download information icon with a play button. It's going to say that there's a build in progress and it's going to start to put together this blank configuration that we have here. And then it's going to ask you, a window will pop open, what do you want to download to the controller? In this particular case, just hardware configuration and logic. So the top two selections. We don't want to initiate any forced values or write anything to flash memory. That's not what we're trying to do here. So I'm going to select OK. Again, that's just the top two selections, hardware configuration and logic. The build will continue to progress. And then it's going to ask you if you want to start the controller or outputs enabled. Yes or OK. All right. Now, if the processor is in good working condition, it'll go into run mode, as you see here. So the green LED next to run should come on as soon as you ask it to start the controller. Now that the controller is in run mode, what I want to do, again, if this is a processor that I think that could be troubled, is I want to let it run for a couple days, 2 or 3 days, you know, maybe in a warm room, a hot environment. And what I'm trying to do is to put it, simulate that it's in a situation where it's working and see if I can create a fault or a problem. So if I come back after 2 or 3 days and it's still in run mode and there is no faults or errors and everything is fine, I believe that the processor is in good working condition. If for some reason it jumps out of run mode or if it kicks itself out of run mode, what I would want to do is go to target again. And then 3/4 of the way down that window is diagnostics. And when you click on Diagnostics, your Info Viewer tab will become a Fault Table Viewer, and it'll give you any errors or faults that the processor has had within the time that you've started it to the time that it may have kicked itself out of run mode. So you want to pay attention to what those errors are. Sometimes they're understandable and sometimes they're not understandable. They're technical information that's difficult to interpret. So if you do have a processor that has failed, or you think that it is failed or has a problem, any of these things that I mentioned, we do repair these processors here at PDF Electric and Supply. And we offer exchange programs, new and remanufactured products, and same day shipping. So if that's something that you need or interests you, please see us at pdfsupply.com. Thank you.